Hey everybody, this is Tippy.
And this is Jo.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/the barn. If it's all right, I want to kick it with you all night, all night. Woo. Have a good time. We will. Ain't got to worry because it's all right, it's all right.
All night, all night, all night, baby. Don't be shy, don't be shy, don't be shy. I feel like everybody always does the same thing for birthday food, though. It's always pizza or burgers.
Well, and that's because you can get, you know, $5, what do you call it? Little C's.
Little C's.
Little C's.
Those haven't been $5 for a minute now. They're like $7.25
or something
like that. You still go in and say, can I get a $5 pizza? And they know what you're asking for.
And they're like, yeah. And then they wink at you. And they're like, you'll get it for $5. Wink, wink. Oh, gosh. Those people.
Freaking pizza inflation, man.
Pizza inflation.
I mean,
they already got
everywhere.
All those hidden fees.
True. On the pizza?
Yeah. Have you never noticed that when you order pizza and it's like, oh, $5.99 a pizza if you get three? Oh, all right, I'll get three. So $5.99, that's $6 times three. That should be $18. No, it's $35.
Yeah, how'd that happen?
Yeah, weird pizza math. I think the same people doing their math as the toilet paper roll people.
Oh, my gosh.
They're like, these eight rolls equal 72 mega rolls.
Right? And it's like, I don't know about that.
Like, has the pizza restaurants always charged a delivery fee?
I'm pretty sure.
Back in the 80s.
Well,
the
even 90s. When you pick it up, there's like weird. It's always way more. Oh. Even if you just pick it up.
It's really way cheaper when I pick it up.
Got that pizza tax. Hmm. It's like the pink tax, but it's for pizza.
Let's assume like delivery's a perk, so that's why. But I'm sitting here thinking whenever they had the, you know, 45 minutes or less or it's free back
they
in the 80s.
They stopped doing that because there were so many wrecks.
Oh.
Yeah, because the pizza because the pizza drivers were like, because it would come out of their check if they got there.
Oh my God. Yeah. So a company's going to establish a special deal
and then
thing
charge
and
then
charge the employee for it. That's
so
hilarious.
They cut that out because the drivers were going so fast trying to make it in time because they'd get in trouble if they, you know, had to give away free pizza.
Yeah.
And then they wrecks here and there.
Miss those days. I just invested in some road cones. Yeah. You just put them out along the path. You know which way they're coming from. You just block the road a little bit, slow them down.
Oh my gosh.
You're free the pizza
worst.
Left and right.
What's your favorite pizza?
So Casey's was my favorite pizza for a long time.
We were stuck on Casey's.
And I still really like Casey's pizza. But Hunt's Brothers, man.
That do slap.
It's really good.
You ever had Hunt's Brothers pizza? You can get it from like Country Mart or Harps now.
Did you feed me one the other day?
Did we?
The buffalo chicken?
No.
That was a store-bought pizza. So Hunt's Brothers is like...
It's like
you
gas
can get it at like gas stations or grocery stores where they have the deli where they cook the pizza. It's like Chester's chicken. You know what I mean? Like how you can get Chester's chicken everywhere. It's just like the brand. It's really good.
The only gas station pizza I eat is Casey's.
Casey's does have great pizza, but I don't know. I think I got burnt out on it. They do so much cheese on it, and it's like just... Mm-hmm.
I keep meaning to try the one in Farmington where they can make it for you and then you can bring it home and freeze it.
I'm pretty sure that place closed down.
No, it didn't.
Papa Murphy's?
It did close and then it reopened and I think it closed again and I think it reopened.
They need to make up their mind.
No.
Because people don't want to cook their own pizzas.
They're like, oh,
well, I think they
yeah.
cook them too.
No, they don't.
They don't? That's
no, you got to take them home
yeah,
and cook
them. Yeah, you take them home and cook them.
It's like the Subway of pizza.
It's like
you go down the
dine out, but you still got to cook it yourself.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
They're like, convenient. Just kidding. You gotta
it's
take
like,
it
can I just get
it.
Some crust from you then? Can you just shape them for me and then I get my own toppings?
Sometimes I go through McDonald's, I'm like, can I just get some frozen nuggets? Don't worry about cooking them.
I'll cook them.
But cut the price in half if you don't mind.
They might sell frozen nuggets.
Probably. Not on purpose.
What's your favorite pizza, Jo?
My favorite pizza? Like pizza place, brand? Is that what we're talking
in
about?
In general, at all.
I
if you're going to eat
pizza, it doesn't matter.
Where do you hope it's from?
On my pizza.
Like your dream pizza. What's your absolute favorite pizza to eat?
Pogolino's in DeSoto.
Ooh, they do have good pizza. They do have good pizza.
Yeah, like that's...
That's how I felt. There used to be a place in Farmington called Bobberino's, and oh, God.
But then, like, I'm a Pizza Hut person, but when I think of Pizza Hut, I also think of the 96 Pizza Hut, you know?
Like the book at Pizza Hut. You're just going there.
The only kind of pizza I like from Pizza Hut is their stuffed crust pizza.
Oh, yeah.
It's just different.
Which usually if I'm getting Pizza Hut, it's because I am getting a stuffed crust, pepperoni pizza, and the breadsticks. I don't care what anyone says.
I just don't like Pizza Hut's crust. Like, I feel like it just tears up the inside of your mouth. It's way... I don't know.
No, it's because you got that pussy ass palate.
Kind of sweet. Yeah, that's it.
But no, I would literally go to Qdoba and get the queso cheese.
Yeah.
And then go to Pizza Hut to get the breadsticks.
You must have been stoned out of your mind.
No,
just making that extra chip for cheese.
I am a 2-restaurant goer. I will go to one and get something I want, and go to another one and get what I want to make the combo.
I love it.
Yeah.
I do love food, so, I mean, that is something I would definitely do.
Thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this episode. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service, and it's 100% online. With BetterHelp, you can tap into networks over 30,000 licensed and experienced therapists who can help you with a wide range of issues. To get started, you just answer a few questions about your needs and preferences in therapy. That way, BetterHelp can match you with the right therapist from their network. Then you can talk to your therapist however you feel comfortable, whether it is via text, chat, phone, or video call. You can message your therapist at any time and schedule live sessions when it is convenient for you. If your therapist isn't the right fit for any reason, you can switch to a therapist at no additional charge. With BetterHelp, you get the same professionalism and quality you expect from an in-office therapist, but with a therapist who is custom-picked for you, more scheduling flexibility, and at a more affordable price. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/thebarn. That's BetterHelp.com/thebarn.
This episode is brought to you by Copper Fox Contrived, located at 361 West Main Street, Park Hills, Missouri. Handmade gifts and wood flowers.
Looking for the perfect venue to host your next unforgettable event? Look no further than the Ashler, located at 316 West Main Street in Park Hills, Missouri. Whether you're planning a dream wedding, organizing a training event, hosting a thrilling trivia night, or even craving the excitement of a live concert, the Ashler is your ultimate destination. With its versatile space and personable host, the Ashler sets the stage for an extraordinary experience. Their dedicated team is there to bring your vision to life, ensuring every detail is flawless and unforgettable. From their stunning decor to their top-notch audio-visual equipment, the Ashler provides the perfect backdrop for your special occasion. Their experienced staff will work with you to create a customized event that exceeds your expectations. Visit theashler.net today to learn more about their exceptional service and reserve your date at the Ashler.
I used to love it whenever we used to always do the A's on the report cards, because different restaurants give out different stuff for A's on your report cards.
Yeah.
So when I was a kid, like, I was a little fat kid. So I was like, I got to get some A's so I can get that free food from the restaurants. Because what we would do is we would go to all the places in one day.
Oh, my God.
And be like, all right, let's just get it all. And then we would just feed the whole family off that, like a little of that, a little of that. That's where our fat kid lunches kind of originated for me.
That's smart thinking.
Yeah.
We used to do, Kyle and I used to do fat kid lunches. We would go to the gas station and just get like one of everything from the gas station deli case, you know? Like, so we'd have like burritos and chicken strips and potato wedges.
A sample
and
of
give
batter.
Me one of them Crispitos and just a little bit of everything. Mm-hmm. I love a good variety night. Sometimes we do those at home too. Like, we'll just have like appetizers for dinner and we'll just go buy like a shit ton of random stuff, like jalapeno poppers. And I'm the only one eating those, but they're delicious.
Well, like, that's like the girl dinner, which I know guys participate in it too, but someone was joking and like, it's been going around, girl dinner, but they're like, a raisin or a peanut, and this bitch, she made one, and she's like, no, this is what a girl, and it was like macaroni and cheese, some pickles, some ham.
Yes.
Just, like, all sides.
Things, like, random.
Snackies.
She's like,
that's
this
at
is girl dinner.
Absolutely.
We eat, okay? We that's eat.
Funny. That's my favorite, is just a variety of foods. I'm a snacker, so I just love all the different flavors. I got to have the flavor. Mm. That's why I like a good variety.
I think that's what I like about pizza. Like, no matter what your tastes are, you can find a pizza that you will like.
See, for me, that's tacos. Tacos are my all-time favorite because you can have them in so many different ways.
Can you?
And I love, you ever, well, you don't like different things. So for you, tacos are tacos.
Yeah.
But for me, But buffalo all your chicken tacos, fish tacos, white people tacos, brisket tacos.
Like, you're allowed to say white people tacos. Yeah,
right. When I say white people tacos, people know exactly what I'm talking about. They're like, oh, ground beef? Yes.
Luckily, just calls them Kyle tacos.
Kyle tacos. Well, those are not white people tacos. Because that's shredded chicken.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Yeah. That is true.
But those be delicious.
Those are so good. Lunch lady tacos are where it's at.
But they do call them Kyle tacos because their regular shredded chicken taco has like pico and all kinds of deliciousness on it. Not a Kyle taco.
I'm like, hold the deliciousness.
Chicken cheese. Yeah. He's like, just give me the standard. I want the basic package. Nothing else on it. But I like tacos because I love like fresh foods, like fresh veggies and stuff.
Uh-huh.
And tacos, you pile that on. Yes. And when I make a taco, it's more veg than meat. When I make a sandwich, too, that's why I like sandwiches.
Like, I love lettuce.
Me,
gross.
Too.
I love lettuce with my tacos. Best. Jeremy doesn't like it. And I'm like, I have to have that crisp crunch.
I hate it. And it contaminates everything it touches. No. Everything it touches tastes like dirty lettuce water.
Oh, no.
Everything. And people are like, can't you just take it off? I'm like, I can, but I can still taste the dirty lettuce water.
I was chopping some lettuce yesterday. Yeah. And I meant to bring you some of that artichoke salad, but I didn't. Oh. I'm mean. But
I'm so sad right now.
And I'm like, you want to know how you survive in the wild? Find you a piece of lettuce and it turned into a cup, you know. I was like, look at all that water.
It's a
lettuce
twofer.
Is amazing.
Yes.
I hate it.
Mm-mm. And it's full. I mean, it's not very like nutrient dense, but it do got a lot of water.
You even put lettuce on your taco pizza.
Yeah.
See, that's where you ruin a pizza.
You ever had a taco pizza, Kyle?
Fuck no.
Oh,
one time at work, my boss was like, oh, we're ordering pizza for the whole crew. And he's like, get like 3 or 4 taco pizzas. Everybody loved taco pizzas. You know what was left over at the end of the meeting?
Taco pizzas. Oh,
like
my gosh.
2.5 of them.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I don't like taco pizzas.
Why do you order
much?
So many taco pizzas?
Because he loves taco pizzas and assumed everybody.
He had never had one. He had just heard everybody talk so highly.
Oh, my gosh.
Did they come from Casey's,
they
though?
Casey's, yeah.
I bet that is good, though. You know, something that a pizza that I never think that I like, but that I eat and I'm like, okay, that is good, is a barbecue pizza.
Oh, yeah.
Casey's used to make a barbecue pizza and my parents used to get that. I'm sure they still make it. But when I was younger, my parents used to always get the barbecue pizza and I'd always be like, ugh, disgusting. And then I'd eat it and be like, damn, that's good as hell.
Yeah.
I'm just not big on barbecue sauce. So anytime anything is like barbecue saucy, I'm always like, I'm not going to like that. But then I do.
Yeah, I'm sure it's not horrible, but I'm definitely a red sauce, white sauce person on meat.
Red sauce. I'm red sauce on everything.
Yeah. I like that white sauce, though.
Yeah.
I like a spinach, chicken, feta, tomato.
The bacon on it. Yeah.
Yes.
It basically makes like a carbonara or an Alfredo pizza.
It's so good.
All right. You guys ready for lunch? What the hell?
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Now I'm hungry.
And that's funny. Yeah,
from parties to pizza.
Yeah. Because every party has to have pizza, right?
Have to.
I do feel like that's for sure the most popular party food just because it's quick and easy. Yeah, and serves so many. And
yeah. Yeah. Mm. And you don't got to cook it.
I think it's funny. We go to Walmart and like Lil Yachty has his own frozen pizza brand now.
Which I've tried and it's all right, but it's nothing
crazy delicious.
Feel
like it would be like
delicious.
This thin, like bar pizza.
No.
Don't get your pizza at the bar. Do you
it
ever
was
get
way
so
better
mad
than bar.
Paying
it's way
like
better than bar pizza.
Oh my for gosh. A $4
frozen
like pizza.
Pizza. Yes. That's the worst.
Bar pizzas. Bullshit.
It is.
If you're a bar out there listening to this, stop fucking serving shitty pizza. What the fuck?
Right? Do better, please. Do you like Emo's pizza?
Oh, yeah.
Me
I love
too.
All pizza. Like, let's be real.
There's not a lot of pizza that I don't like.
I could have lived without Papa John's, unfortunately. Sometimes I'd be craving it.
I don't even remember Papa John's.
Yeah.
Oh, no,
why
wait.
Do they put that thing in the... I don't want a pepper in
well,
the box.
Well, I love pepperoncini, so I'm cool with them putting that in the box.
Yeah, no.
But where were we? We were in St. Louis, right? And we got Papa John's, because that was the only place that was open.
Yeah, when we went to Bert Kreischer.
I was like, man, I don't know if I've ever had Papa John's. And then we got it, and I was like, damn, this is probably why.
I feel like they're not that good with their toppings, but then the crust doesn't hold up to the amount of toppings.
Yeah.
Like it's like,
and it's not like a tasty crust.
Yeah.
You got to have a good crust, and you got to have a good sauce.
Uh-huh. It's all you need.
That's it. Then you're set.
And good cheese.
Yeah.
That's not... Gotta have good cheese.
You gotta have that stringy, melty cheese. Mm. That's where it's at.
And that's why people are like emos, because like we have to say emos wins with having the best cheese.
Yes, that Provel cheese is where it's at. And I love that you can buy it in store, because like I'll make sandwiches at home and put them in the oven.
Did you buy the whole block?
No.
Because I went in one day to get a half a pound of shredded cheese and they looked at me like I was stupid.
Why?
Little girl tried to pull it up on the computer. It's like, well, I didn't get a manager. I was like, well, I mean, if you don't have a button that just sells the cheese, then...
What the heck?
Yeah, because his grandma bought some in Festus.
Mm-hmm. You can buy it. Like, they have it...
In store they do.
Yeah, yeah. Like, Schnucks has it. They have, like, the rope kind, which is so good. So there used to be a restaurant on the hill.
Man, I want to shred
it. Oh, my gosh. But the rope kind is so good in salads. It's so good.
Oh, yes, it is. Yes. That's what they put in Pogolino's.
Yes, yeah.
And that's what they put on their pizzas. That's why I'm like, oh, yeah.
Probably.
What kind of cheese is it?
The Provel cheese, like Emo's has.
Oh, whenever I was a kid, we were told that was goat cheese.
Oh. Goat
so that's
cheese?
Why I was like, why would they use goat cheese on this pizza?
Goat cheese is good,
I mean,
though.
It would probably be richer.
I don't know. I never liked Emo's until I got with Tiffany, and then I was like, this isn't bad.
It's really good. I love Emo's. I used to, that would be like the only pizza I would eat. I loved Emo's pizza.
When I was a kid, I used to listen to a lot of Taken Back Sunday when I'd eat pizza, so every pizza was Emo pizza.
Oh, my God. Get out of here. Oh, gosh. You're too much, man. Hey, everybody. This is Tippy.
And this is Joe.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/The Barn. If it's all right.